Hello, it's Sarah. I'm going to do some jelly prints today. This is my jelly plate by Gelli. It's the 8x10, I think. Anywho, I like it. So, I'm in my craft room, and I've only ever really done it on my kitchen counter because I like to spread out. But I'm going to try it in here today. Probably just going to print on, I have some cardstock and I have some printer paper. So we'll see how it goes. And I'm going to try these paints. I went in the basement to look for some paint. And I have these from different classes I've taken. Josonia was a big brand for a more artist quality paint back in the day, and I had several colors. I mean, they're a lot of different mixy blendy. I like the sapphire. This is a pretty aqua. Naphthol crimson, white, definitely need that. And then I also found these are by her son, Jansen Art Traditions, and I have Naphthol Red. I'll keep that. But they're just good quality. They're $5 a pop, and I'm not using them, so I'm using them on my jelly plate. So I have white. So I'm going to play. And then I also had these, which are Galleria. So this is Ultramarine Blue. I'll probably try that. Cad Scarlet. Iridescent Green. Ooh, I didn't know I had that. Burgundy, Yellow Oxide, and Teal. So yeah, I'm going to mix those in today. What else? I've also just pulled, of course, some just super bright colors that I love. Going to work with my big stamps that I made. And these are kind of like geometric patterns. I got this from Patty Tolley Parrish. She has a video on how she did these, and it's just using kids' craft foam. So I have a couple of those, and then I have smaller ones. So I just figured I'd work with them instead of stencils today. I did stencils last time, and then you know what? You can always come back with stencils after and add a little color and design if you just kind of got like a blob. Because I mean, this was requested that I do, that I share some jelly prints. I really don't have a process. You know me and my process. But I figured, what the heck, I'll just try and see what happens. So I have my brayer, and it's a mess. My brayer is all clumpy. This is the Speedball brayer. And I have my little, I have a composition book over to the side of me that I kind of wipe off my brayer with. And we're just going to start. And I mean, I'll probably get messy. I'm going to try and keep calm and not have, because I don't really even know where I'm going to be putting these to dry. But let's just get started. Now, for the piece we're going to do, which is going to be the tissue box, I'm going to do some, like, I need some yellows for a sun, a cat. What else are we going to do? Maybe a bird and a bee skep. So let's just do some yellow right now, since I have this beautiful Hansa yellow. It's a medium viscosity acrylic. I don't know. So I'll put some of this down, and I'm going to just do it calmly. I usually fling paint everywhere, and it gets a little crazy. I'm going to add... See, this is the thing. When I'm not on camera, I would just do whatever and not care. But I think I'm like thinking now. I'm trying to make it like it's going to be. You know what? Let's add orange. Yes. Oh, I have cad yellow. This is a bit. I don't have much. But I'm trying to make it like have a little variation. It doesn't look like much. But we, like I said, we can always add. Yeah, they're different. Actually turned a little green. All right, now I'm just rolling off my brayer, and I'm going to take this kind of geometric pattern and just give it a little wiggle. You know what you can do too? You can take, see, I'm not gonna have enough room. But you can take a piece of paper and put it on top of that and get the reverse image. So I'll show you that. And then you can also get, oh, itchy nose. This one. So here, this is just from the stencil. So you at least get some color on there, right? So this is your first one. It's a very, it has a little bit of design, but I wish I would have taken off more paint with the stencil, but I'll go back on top of this one and pick up the rest of that, and we'll try it again. Maybe I won't put as much paint on there, but yeah, I'm not a professional at this at all. I'm gonna do more yellow though. Maybe I'll add a little orange to this one. And look, now I'm swirling. So let's add a little orange to this one. And maybe I'll take that, one of those other ones I just did, and get a I like orange. I'm starting to like orange. I've never been a huge orange fan, but I'm going to wiggle it a little more. Try to lift up more paint. Ooh, that is so pretty. I'm taking the same one. Nah, you know what? We'll do a different one. And this is just printer paper. So nothing fancy. Now look at the second one though. This is pretty, very pretty. I'm gonna take this one and this one. No. I'm so confused. All right. You know what? I always get really warm when I do this. It's like you're working. You have to work out. See, that's cool. It put the orange on there, so that's good. And maybe I'm just going to leave that alone. Like, don't. Sometimes you don't have to keep. Oh, look, there was totally paint left on here. On top of my stencil. It's cold here in New Jersey. See, look. But sometimes you don't have to. I have an issue, like, as being a heavy hand. Meaning like I just go for it with color. Like I don't hold back, and sometimes more is too much, you know. So there is kind of that balance. You have to find a balance. Let's see. So these are looking pretty good. I don't like this paper as much. I haven't really done a lot on printer paper. I'm gonna switch to my cardstock. I'm used to working with that. It's much thicker, but, all right, let's do, I'm going to try some green. What color? This green. Such a pretty green. It's apple green, I think. Oh, olive green. And I think that'll look cool with those yellows and oranges under there. Oh, look, it's clumpy. My paint is really old, so I don't know what I'm going to get. And then this is an iridescent green. And let's just see what happens. But I'm a messy jelly plater. I should probably put my apron on because I fling paint everywhere. But I'm pushing a little hard to get that to kind of go down. And then I'm gonna use a different one, this one. Do the same thing. These are so easy to work with because they're big. and wiggle that. I'm going to put the yellow one on there. That's just the what's going to come off the and you know, you could do more stuff. What else did I? Oh, well, let's just get this. But you can I have these. I just cut these with decorative scissors so you can do the lines in them, and I'll do that too. You can do a couple things, but for now, I'm just kind of, oh, I like that. Can't really see. I like it. I don't know if you're picking it up. Wow, that really, happy with that. Just trying to find places to put these. Here's another one. I think I'm going to put that green on here, although that wouldn't be good for a sun. Oh, it's stuck. Look, that one's cool. The little bit of orange came off too, onto it. So there's a little bit of green left. I'm going to go back with the yellow. Just stay in one color family for now. You know what? I have to add pink. I mean, I'm just going to mix it up and see what happens, because there's a little bit of green. And let's do these flowers. So my yellow and green is making orange. No, yellow and pink is making orange. Look at that. So I'm going to take this one. It looks like the 60s. And I'm just putting it on that other one. I'll put it on here. But I'm going to take pretty. I don't know. I need a shadow. What's it called? A shadow print? Or a... Gotta push a little harder. Get it to come off the plate. There we go. Look at that. That's so cool. See, I'm having success. See, I'm happy because I didn't want to just get out here or get on here and make a bunch of bleh. I'm going to do that again with a little bit of yellow. And I love pink. Let's put magenta. This is more of a purpley pink. And I think that's it. That's all I'm going to do for that. And it is turning orange. Pink and yellow make orange. I'm going to do those flowers again. This is a much darker color, orange, too, so this might actually be nice for a sun. I'm just going to go over to this and do the what's on the stencil. Yeah, it's definitely a darker. But look, see, the, you can see the pink. We'll see what this is. I'll bet you the shadow print is nice. I like it. I like using these stamps. I think I like using these better than stencils. I could go away and get a few stencils and show you the difference, but let's do this shadow print and see what that pulls off. Although, I could get that if I add more. I'm just going to add the pink. Just pink, maybe a little metallic pink. See, I don't know what I'm doing. Not that I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm not doing this for any specific reason. So don't, you know, it's just something, it's just whatever I feel like doing. This is serious playing. You have to just play and let it go and not try to make something specific. I like the flowers. I'm in flower mode. I'm just turning my page over here. And that's like a coral color. Ooh. That turned out pretty. And that's the thing. With mono printing, it's very hard to duplicate what you do. I mean, maybe you could get similar versions, but you're not going to be able to duplicate. And I'm just going to take this and put it on that same where I've been putting all the impressions. That's way pinker. Oh my gosh, I love it. Okay. I have polka dots, or not polka dots, but yeah, polka dots. Look, I just made dots. I have these. I ordered these from Amazon. These are by Wendy Vecchi. No, not Wendy Vecchi. Some other name. Can't think of her name. Wait. It almost came to me. I can't think of it. And they're just considered... Oh, look at that pink. That is so pretty. I love that. I really like working with these stamps. Oh, there goes that one onto the floor. Because I'm going to put that on top of here. Because you get thin color and thick color. So you pull off almost down to the white and you get versions of the pattern. I don't know what I'm trying to say, but it's cool. So let's see if that pink will come up on here. Yep. Wow, I like that. This has a little bit of everything, a little bit of green, but I think I'm gonna be done with this. And then, if I want to, I can add stencil, but I like that. That's good. Okay. So, and then I'll show you what we made. I'm really liking the colors. Those are just getting this one. And maybe I'll just stay with pink. Let me see here. This is like a really like an autumn orange and pink. Isn't that pretty? I want to be done with that one too. I don't want to, sometimes you have to be done. Now this one was just where I was putting all the, just putting the stamp down to take the color off the stamp. Let's see if I have any more. Oh, I just put my finger, yeah, I had more. I just got green on me right there. And then we have this green one. So far so good. I'm feeling pretty, happy with these that I've gotten so far. Let me do some polka dots so we can see what that looks like. And you know what? I have a feeling that taking this and using it as a stamp, I'm going to like better than, well, not necessarily better, but so I think he can be done. That was just more of like a residual. This one's cool. Do I need to add? This has so much thick green on it. I'm going to let that dry for a minute. This is such a pretty color. And there's the metallic pink. What did I put on here? Metallic. Yeah, I must have used metallic. All right, so we've used both of the super big ones. Let's see. I don't think I've used this one. I think I only used the other one, so let's do this one. Let's get into some blues. I want to use this. This is Galleria Ultramarine. Ugh, I don't even know if I can open it. Ugh. I'm going to get my pliers. Huh, can't even, nope, can't grab it. I'll have to get, oh, I can't do it. Screw it, we can't do it. This is Sapphire by Jo Sonia. Oh, but it's such a nice thick paint. It's a little less vibrant, but you know what? We could add some of this lovely metallic by Delta, yeah, Ceramco Bobby Blue Pearl. And how about, like, I want a little light blue. Should we add aqua? See, it gets crazy. Sometimes if you add too much, oh, geez, that wasn't shooken up. And that is not good, so I'll take that off. I'm not used to working with these tubies. All right. Try that again. I don't even know if I want to add that. Where's that? We're good. I'm just going to do those two. We'll do some blue with the other geometric stamp that I made. I like the feeling I'm having right now too, of like, I'm not rushing, and I'm just, I don't know, sometimes I really didn't have good luck with my last session. I was using stencils, and I don't know, I like, let's see how this goes. So now I can should I put the blue on top of here? This looks so pretty though. Blue and green. I like blue and green. Got a piece of paper. That looks pretty cool. I mean, I don't hate it. The blue isn't a bright blue, though. That blue is more of, I don't know what you would call it. Ooh. But I like it. I like these stamps. These stamps are just super cool. Aqua. Let's try the aqua. They're not bright brights. Ooh, actually, that's not bad. I don't mind that. And then maybe I'll add some of this green iridescent. I mean, aqua and green aren't the same. Ooh, look, it comes out white. Oh, wow. Ooh. These are so old. I don't even know. I mean, I shook them pretty good. What it does. Pretty, I like it. I'm gonna do that big stamp one more time. I haven't used it. Give it a wiggle. And I think I'm gonna do the, what is it called? The positive, the negative and the positive. I'm gonna do with a brand new sheet. So to make those, I have some more foam too that I can make another stamp with. I could do a tutorial for you, and but I mean, they are out there. I know Patty Tully Parish has one, and that aqua's pretty. I like the aqua. But see, I'm still even getting blue and green, different colors. Let's see the negative, or the, I guess it would be the positive. I really like the stamped version of them. And you get stuff from, like, there's red on there. So I like that. All right, let's see. I want to stay with that aqua for another round, but what else could I add to it? Blue. I like the green. Maybe a green metallic? Do you think that'll screw it up? I like it. I think that might look good. We'll see. Just have to try it. I like it. Oops. Gotta push a little harder. And one more time with this one. Let's see. I'm gonna get some of this. And I want to get the negative of it. Should I do? I'll do a different paper. Just do a different one. I'll do it on printer paper. And I'll do this on don't see a lot of the green. I'm telling you, the stamped versions are cool. Very, very cool. Okay, babe. I'm gonna add that magenta. And I gotta add metallic. Some metallic. Rose metallic. And I think I'll do one of the different stamps. Let's see. Oh yeah, the dots. I definitely gotta do dots. And this, now that blue should get picked up with it. Excuse me. All right, I'm gonna change pages. Let's do some dots. See, the blue and the green are coming through. I like these stamps a lot. And you could do more, so what should I put them on? I kind of want to put it on here. See the blue came through? I like it. And it's metallic. I really like, people ask me how do I get my shine on a lot of stuff, and it's just because I'm using this metallic paint on a lot of things, like my backgrounds, and that's usually what it is. So this is just, let's see. I like this color a lot. Keeping you. I like this a lot too. See, I have to stop myself and just know that it's good enough. Like, and even though all the white's not covered, so what? Why do I need all the white covered? And like I said, then you can go over with your stencils or just stamp on top of it. I was just trying to pick up some of that residual on there. All right, so we're doing good. I'm gonna be done in a minute and show you what we've created. I love this. This turned out so good. Now, these I think I bought. All these little flowers came in a self-sticking kids bin in the kids section. These hearts I think were the same thing. I just stuck them down to a piece and made a stamp out of it. So let's do some red. I brought this down. This is the David Jansen Traditions, and it's naphthol red. And of course, all this other stuff, but this is such a good quality paint. But let's do some hearts. Red and what? I could just add white to make a little pink. Let's do that. I think I brought down the big, thick David Jansen white. Now I can't say it. Sorry. I'm blind. Aww. I don't see it. Titanium white. I'll use this. I thought I brought down the big one because I probably did. Oh, yeah, I did. Here it is. I just left it in the... These are $5 a tube. I'll just put three dots. So hopefully it'll be pink, red, and white, right? But look how that paint is nice and thick. This is gonna be so pretty. I don't do a lot of red. I think my son just came home. Oh, I love the color. It's not quite, it's got that corally feel to it. So let's do some hearts. I'll do this. It's windy out and cold. It snowed here, but, and it's stuck on all the trees and the grass and everything. Now I have this. I'm just gonna stamp it on that. But it didn't stick to the roads or anything, so it was perfect. Because I like snow, but not when it's causing problems. Now this is just smaller hearts. We'll see what happens. Oh, darn. Darn. See what happens, right? These are good. All right, so let me get a piece of... My husband raised my camera, so I'm pretty happy about that. Probably still won't be in the shop, but at least I can do bigger things and you can see a wider area of what I'm working with. The second one is going to be even better. Watch this. I think. Maybe not. But it's something. It's pretty cool. Alright, so now all that is on there. So I want to do some more red. I don't have a lot of red. I'm going to use the red and white again, maybe just a little less so it's not as thick. And yeah, that's hard for me, but I could do the polka dots this time. We haven't done the polka dots yet. And I have a couple of different polka dot stencils. I love this color. It's so pretty. Valentine's Day is coming, and that's when The Walking Dead comes back, which I'm more excited now. I do love my Walking Dead. So here's the dots. So cute. These are, and like, I could just make a big one. I should just make a big one of dots because, oh, let's use this on here. Because then you just have a big dot thing. How, it's not expensive. These foam things are not expensive, so. And I love having those big stamps. They just work great. Something about the foam makes it like more textural, makes the design I don't know, I'm gonna do it. I think I'm gonna make a whole big heart one. Like, I don't know, I think so. Okay, so that's some polka dotty, but now you know what you do, you go on top of it with white polka dots and pink polka dots or something, right? So get any off that really. Now these could be done, I guess, right? I want to add something else to them. Let's just see. This is where, when, see, this is so pretty. Like, it's just good red color and there's a little bit of something, like, I like them. There's a little bit of design, not too much metallic. I don't think I put metallic on there. I am going to, let's see what other stamps I haven't used yet. The swirlies and this big swirly and big flower. Let's do these and then I might get a couple stencils. What colors do I want to do? I'm really loving the red and I don't have a lot of red. So I think I'm going to do a couple more red. Like, you kind of just have to make at least 5 sheets of each color or something, you know, because that way, let's put some metallic, I think purple. I'm gonna try it. I don't know, might make mud. Ooh, that was big. And I think that's all. That's all I'm gonna do. Maybe white would have been good. I think adding the metallics definitely gives it texture too. I like red and purple together, so let's use this one. And I'm gonna put that on top of this one. I have a kind of a plain one over here. And you know what else I'm gonna do? I'm gonna use this and do just that. See what that looks like. I'll grab 2 pieces of paper. Pretty cool. The purple is, you can see it in the shine, but you can't see it to look at it for, okay, cool. Like, if you only see the purple when you, all right, I don't know what I'm trying to say. Let's just do purple. Hold on, I grabbed, this is just straight purple. Yep, acrylic purple. Oh, it's dried out. Oh, there it comes. Wow, that's intense. That's dark. Now, where's the light? Let's put a little bit of this amethyst with it. And that's it. I'm not going to put metallic right now. Let's see what this looks like. Do that again, just straight. I think that was, this is my thicker line. And just do, a little bit of the red shows through. And let me put a little bit of purple on here. Hopefully it'll pick up that purple. Eh, not too much, but I like it. So I maybe, I gotta do, let's do purple again. I'm loving purple. See, this is kind of boring. Ooh, the metallic. But see, there's so much purple left on there. And that bright, bright purple. I just, ow, my arm is starting to hurt. Because I press so hard. I am not gentle. I'm going to do it lefty. I can roll lefty. Ooh. So this has a lot of metallic in it. Let me use this again. And I'm gonna do swirls. And that's it. And I'm gonna put this one, this polka dotty one on it. And this will be red and purple for sure. Maybe not push as hard. And maybe I won't get all the, not bad. I kind of lost some of the circles are still showing. And then let's do this on there and see what happens to that. I gotta make more reds because I turn them into red and purples. And that picked up just enough, so that'll be done. I like that one. I'm gonna do a couple more reds now because I lost, this one's done. And this one, I think I might just leave it done because it's just a purple. This red, I don't want to ruin it. It could just use some white. I think I want to do, these are just, ooh, I have this guy. I kind of want to do white polka dots on here. Oh jeez, that scared me. Alright. Because the way I want to do it is with a stamp. So maybe I'll just do it. What the heck, right? Just use this as like a stamp pad. And roll it out. And get this. So I can't really move that. It's like stuck to my surface, but I'll show you when I'm done. So I'm going to use this as my, as a stamp and just add a little bit of, I don't want to cover up all my other stuff, but see, I like it. Alright, so I hope you guys are kind of getting an idea of what, oh, you know what, we got to add a little bit of white to this too, why not? And I hope you're understanding that I haven't even used a stencil today. I made all the stuff that I'm using and I am actually loving the results I'm getting. There's a little bit of red in here. Kind of more than I even, I didn't like my last batch that I did with stencils, but I think it had to do with the process I was using. I was trying to do solid color, like I didn't mix any paint. I think mixing paint, definitely for me, I have always gotten a much better result when I mix paint on the, so I was trying to do solid color, stencil, lift, then do another solid color, and then do another stencil, and like it just wasn't coming out as like rewarding. But I like this. Look at that. I love that. Do I have another really dark paper that I could do that with? I love it. Thank you, Matt. I'm filming, Bubby. This is so pretty. I don't think I want to add white to it. So yeah, if you have, see, I got to put something on here. Let's see, maybe just here and there, right? Kind of screwed it up. Not really. That white's kind of stuck there now, though. So what else should I do? What didn't we do yet? This guy. I have blue, pink, orange. Oh, my God. Some of these are so pretty. And I have no idea how I did it. That's the thing. That's why they're monoprints. So let's just look what we have. I'll show you what I have, and you know what, let me just get this off of here with some red, and then I will show you what we made, and I'll call it a day. Might as well do it with one last. Oh, I was going to do that flower, right? Let's do this. love it. And then where's my little stamp off section? I wonder what that white that was on there is going to do. Because it should be on the top if it gets picked up. Nope, it didn't. But I like it. I got a red one again. I like the foam stamps a lot. A lot, a lot, a lot. Oh, wow. That is gorgeous. See that? I'm curious. The ghost print, that's what it's called, not the shadow. They call it the ghost print. Look at that. Wow, that's cool too. I have these though. See, they need, I think they need more. I have tons.
What do I do?
Right, I don't know, because there's still paint on there. I think you're supposed to, maybe, I could just wipe it off. I'm just gonna move this over here, because I'm gonna keep playing. But I wanna show you guys what we made. So, we have a couple that are, sorry, I think I pushed the button by mistake, that are a little less solid, so that's okay. I might, you know, use that again, figure it out. Then I did a couple on printer paper, which I don't know if I like that or not. I think I'm just used to the cardstock. Then this is that red one I just did. Love. It needs metallic. And this one, just this was just residuals that I did. I think it was red hearts, and then I just did a few of the stamping with my circles in white. Love that. That was just solid purple, and then I did the, and there's a little bit of the red left in the white. Like, that's super cool. This one I love and have no idea how I did it. No idea. I guess mixing colors, right? We were mixing red and yellow and stuff. I don't know. A little bit of the green. This is just a swirl. Like it, but I could do something more on top of that. But I like that there's metallic in there. This is when I just like had all the reds and I was adding, but I love red and purple. Teal and purple. The pink. This is just such a pretty pink color. It's like coral. I think it's pink and yellow or something. I blended it together. It made such a pretty color, and I have no idea how I did it. I mean, I can watch this video, maybe figure it out, right? Blue and green, which I love. But there's so much other paint that gets on there that's stuck on the Gelli print. Love the metallics, you guys. I would suggest that. And this was one that I just cleaned up that white with. I tried to, and it kind of went like that. Look at this. So pretty. I mean, a sun. This is kind of more autumn-y, though. Like a tree, an autumn tree. I could do an autumn scene. And this one might need a little more, something else. So many colors, though. Look at that. There's the peach color, yellow, green, so pretty. This is printer paper. And then these are all just either residuals, but look, like that. It's so cool. This is just where I was stamping off my stamp. So I think we had a successful session. I would say so. So I'm gonna continue because I have that much. I could totally make more, and I'm having a pretty successful session. So I'm pretty excited. I'm going to go back to some colors that I really love, and I hope this was helpful. Don't be afraid. It's fun. This is total play, and that's really all I know, though. I don't know any more to tell you. about getting yourself consistent stuff. It's just experience, play. Make yourself some stamps too. They're super fun. So I think I'm gonna do that. All right, you guys. And in the next videos, I'm gonna collect up some papers to do the tissue box. And I think I'm gonna just do the backgrounds in all blues. Like I'll pull a couple blues that look similar, you know, and just use this all the way around the box as a background. And then, and I have a couple that I like. And then we'll start picking colors for, I think I'm gonna do the B-Skep because I really love that and I think it'll fit on there. We'll do the cat because that way I can do, I had a request for the cat in my art journal. I'm debating the bird because I've done so many birds. I'm debating him. The sun, definitely the sun. So the sun, the cat, the B-Skep, and I'll surprise you with the last one. I don't know. All right, you guys. Thanks for watching.